John, Rock and TV One here. We are making a tiny bit of electricity on top of my wood stove.
See?
Oh. With my little Stirling engine you guys saw there the other day. And honestly, I have not got the technical responses that I was hoping to get from the YouTube community. So, I am still working on it. And what I have there on there is one of those shaker flashlights, you know, like this.
Yeah.
You know, one of these here flashlights. Yeah, and you go like this and a little light comes on. The one that I have on there did the 6-foot test and it hit the ground, and so I had to solder it back together. But some of these make more power than others. As you know, this works on the Faraday effect principle by dragging the magnet through that coil. The beautiful thing is that this thing actually does it without loading the motor. Other than the weight of the friction of the magnet going up and down in the cylinder, which I've just sort of concocted onto the side here, really quick, like, see, oh, yeah. Just connected on there with this piece of wire, runs through a hole, and then I just drilled a hole in the thing there, and I got the piston going up inside and down in the little flashlight there. And if I hit the button, you might be able to see the light comes on there. It's not real bright, not hardly real bright at all. But one thing that I wanted to show you is an effect that, if I can plug this light back in here and dock it up, get lucky. Okay, is that if I hold just another magnet next to this here, we get a much better pulse. Of course, it is definitely loading the magnet on the inside at that point. Now, if I was driving a DC motor in a rotary fashion to make electricity, as soon as some device pulled electricity from that DC motor in the generator would then be causing a load on this motor. But because of the circuitry and the capacitor that's in there, all we are doing is charging the circuit. And the load is, as far as I know, and you guys can correct me on this if I'm wrong, the load is not directly connected to this piston going up and down. Therefore, the magnet. Therefore, it's not loading this motor to do its work in any way, shape, or form, except for the weight of the piston and its frictional losses on the engine itself. It's turning approximately 110, about 100 RPM right there, and it is just enough to light that LED with a 3.6 volt cap. And as you can see, if I take this here magnet and put it next to it, I can get that flash going on, which I believe is just because I'm increasing the speed of the magnet going by the coil. You guys can go ahead and give me your opinions, or let's talk tech here. So last year, my engine was running on top of the wood stove at 80, 90, 100 RPM, somewhere in that neighborhood. And that was one pass of the magnet through the coil per second is not quite enough with the button on, with the light on, to keep it from flashing. It doesn't stay lit. when one just isn't enough.